we have here is a couple of spud wrenches. Aaron's got one, I got one. I'm gonna just rest this here. And if we look here, we can see that these two flanges are jamming up a little bit. Now, it's light enough gauge, we're probably gonna be able to get it in to line up these holes, right? But what I wanna show you, here, let's, or here, you go ahead and spud that one. I can spud here. A spud wrench, what a spud wrench is supposed to do, see how these holes aren't lined up at all? A spud wrench will suck the purlin down and nest them properly, right? Or at least line up the holes properly. Here, I think that we have this one incorrect. In fact, I know we do. We're gonna pull this and we're gonna set this one on top of this one and see what we can get. So once. And spud. I'm gonna bring it over. All right, and now you can let the spud go. Yep. Now, without any spud, all of our holes here are lined up a lot better. We're still gonna have to do a little bit of spud work just to get it set down. And you can't see it from that side, but this is a really tight joint here. And well, before we do that, a trick that I like to do is if you're having a hard time lining these up, and depending on the height of the rafter, the deflection on the rafter, these holes are gonna move around a little bit. A cool trick is to come in and go ahead and set your lap bolts first. You got a washer and a nut. And I'm not gonna bother taping this or putting a tape measure on it, but when we're talking about the purlin lap on the roof plan, that 1 inch or 1 foot, 1 3/4, because this is a, or 2 foot, 1 3/4, this is a number two lap. So from here to the center of this clip is gonna measure out 2 foot, 1 3/4 inch.
Should be able to get a pull.
And now that we have this in, all right, and now we can move on to the next one. I'll let these guys keep working up the frame here. All right, see you in the next one.